Hi everyone, welcome back. So in this video we are going to build one search bar application. Okay, very basic application, but it will help you to understand how props works, how state works. Okay, what we are going to do is we have some fixed set of data, something like this. Okay, and we are going to pass this data in our component libraries, and we are going to create a Google search for fixed set of data. So it's not a Google search, right? We are running just a search on these framework names. Whenever you type Angular, all the related content should appear, right? And we are passing this library's data in the app component. So how can I access it? Using this .props.libraries in the app component. Okay, currently it is plain and simple, we don't have much in this. Now how we are going to access the data which is provided from the parent component? We can simply say const libraries equal to this dot props. This is how we will get. So here we are passing libraries. I can access it the same value here, right? And now I will also have one search field, input type text field. Oh man, this caps lock. Input type text, okay. And the value is will be coming from state object. So what value will be here is this dot, okay, let's see, I have a search as a state, so it will be this dot state dot search. Okay, and there will be on change method, and I will be writing on change method here this dot handle change, passing event object. Same event object here, handle change you can write here. Handle change is doing nothing but it is updating the state, and we are using arrow function, so we don't need to explicitly bind search this handle change method with this object. And we can get e.target dot value. We got the search keyword. Now in the render function we have to just write a logic to actually filter the values from the libraries. Okay, first of all we have to get our search key. Search key will be nothing but this dot state dot search we are getting. So we will just do a trim and make it lowercase. This dot search state dot search dot trim dot to lowercase. So because we are going to do a comparison, so we will make both the keys lowercase and then we will do the comparison. And here we can have one array, const library data as an array. Okay, now what we need to check, so you will be typing something in the text field, right? You will be typing something and we have to do the filtering based on that. So whenever this state is getting changed, this render function will get called, and here we will get the updated value of the search string which we have passed, search key, right? Now we need to put a condition like if search key is there and its length is, if length is greater than 0, then we need to apply the search, otherwise this text field is empty, we are not doing anything. So this lib data, here what we will do is in the lib data we will do the filtering, libraries dot filter. This is an array. So what we are doing is we are just comparing the data, return i.name. So we are getting these properties. This is an array we are getting. It has a name and URL, and we are comparing only name. So i.name dot to lowercase and dot match. We are doing match with search key we got. Okay, if it is returning true means that is matching, we are getting that in the lib data. Now in libdata you again got an array and we have to iterate. So for iteration you can simply write ulli, right? I can simply add ulli here, libdata.map in index. It's the same code we have written many times. In the li I am returning this, so you can directly write this in the parentheses. Okay, libdata, because this is an array, it is going to give us an array of li tags, and JSX is comfortable in rendering it, right? So we are getting index, ahref, values and all, right? Now if we just try to run this code, what we are getting, and if we are getting any error. Oh, this is working. You see, I'm typing R, so it is matching with all the results. If they are having this character JS, Angular, React. Okay, this is our first example of talking about creating a basic search bar. I have already written some CSS, which is just about ULLI and input text field, how to customize it. That you can just ignore for now. Just focus on the logic, what we have written. We got props data from the parent component. We were having some local text field. When you are typing something in this text field, we were actually running this calculation check, what new filter result we are getting. And every time whenever you type something character, this new lib data we are receiving and we are assigning it. I mean, we are rendering it, because when you type anything in this text field, state is getting changed, render function will get call, and we see the new set of data on the UI. Okay, I hope this is useful for you guys. Now in another video, we will talk one more example of this kind of application.